Here we go. Yeah, I'm afraid, like I'm scared as a dog, but I've got a new song and I want y'all to sing along. Sing along. See, this is the way that we walk on the sunny day when it's raining and
so that was footage of Sarah going out for a driving lesson. Now, it was supposed to have been Monday, Tuesday, and the schools all start back today, but the guy who was taking her out had some sort of emergency. I think he had a flood in his house. So on Saturday is my brother's wedding, so she can't go out Saturday. Sunday, the teachers, they don't work on a Sunday. So the only day she could do was Wednesday. Now she's doing a 2-day kickstart intensive. So it's 6 hours one day, 6 hours the next day. So she's just back and she quit after 5 hours. She said she just couldn't take any more in. She was all over the place. She was nearly crashing the car. She was going onto the cycle lane. She was taking the corners too wide on the other side of the road. Just a complete hot mess. And then he said to her, like, are you all right? Do you want to stop? And she said, yeah. So we just drove her home. Which, our plan for Sarah was do a 2-day kickstart, and then your dad's going to take you out, and he's not going to take you out without you knowing the basics, because we don't have a dual control car. So she was to go out and do her kickstart. Kids, man. So she's to go out and do her kickstart, then her dad's going to take her out, teach her all our manoeuvres and stuff, and then we're going to put her in for an intense weekend to go and pass her test. But seeing that she can't handle driving for long periods of time, and she's just like at the end, she did tell me yesterday that she was making stupid mistakes at the end of our lesson. I don't think an intense weekend is going to suit her. It suited me, it suited her dad. My brother didn't like an intense, well, our dad did an intense week. I kind of did a whole bunch of lessons, kind of intense, it was kind of custom made. And I passed my test over 3 months, but I took a whole bunch of lessons within those 3 months. And my brother, he passed his test over a weekend. He'd failed a couple of times, so then he took an intense weekend course and passed. So from my experience, they work, but they work on people who can handle concentrating for a long period of time. I don't think Sarah can do that. Going on me teaching her dancing, she's wanting to quit after 10 minutes, and half an hour she's like, Pete, she's at her max, she's done. And she's not the only one that I teach that's like that. So there are people who can concentrate for hours and hours, and they're physically drained, they're mentally drained, and they can still keep going. And there's other people that need breaks, constant breaks, and can't concentrate for long periods of time. So what I think we'll do is I'm going to talk to Sarah about when it all goes wrong, what's her peak, and we might just get a driving instructor that can customise a sort of like intense course, sort of like what I did, because these package deals, it's just going to be an absolute waste of money. She's not got it in her to do 6 hours and then a test. Her brain will be fried, she'll be all over the place, she'll be worse than when she first went out in the morning. So there, that's us. And now I have my brother's wedding rehearsal tonight with the kids. Yes, and then one more lesson before their dance, their first dance.
Sunlight. night comes creeping in, illuminates our skin. We watch the day go by. Story.
Good morning, guys. Today is the day of my big brother's wedding. I'm doing the makeup for the bridal party, so I need to get everyone in this house ready, my mum, my kids, me, and then shoot over at the bride's and do the bridesmaids, the mother of the bride, and of course the bride. So there's a million things I need to do. I can't stand about talking for too long, but I'll show you this. Sorry, the bed and everything is a total mess. Don't look. But here, this is for John. He's the page boy, right? Mr. and Mrs. Kearney, and it's got their wedding date on it. And at the back, ring security. So my sister-in-law, not the one that's getting married, my other brother, so I've got four brothers, by the way. She does like a whole sort, it's like arts and crafts kind of thing she does. Like here, like she made that for me. Okay, so she does all these sort of like things like this. That's the sort of stuff that she does. And she's been helping out a lot in this wedding with all the little extras and stuff. And she said she thought for a ring bearer, holding a pillow is a bit girly. So she came up with this idea. And I love it. It's so cute. She'll open it up and let you see inside. Like I said, what, like, excuse the mess of the house. Keeping it real, guys. Keeping it real. Look what we... Look. They're fake rings. They're not the real rings. But, yeah. Adorable. And all the guys are all going to be in kilts today. Looking very dapper. And I need to go. So thanks for watching, and make sure you watch the wedding video. Bye.
Here we go.
Yeah, I'm afraid, like I'm scared as a dog, but I've got a new song and I want y'all to sing along. Sing along. See, this is the way that we walk.